Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. In this lesson, we will talk about how we can use different living organisms to check the quality of the environment, whether the environment is deteriorating or it is in normal state or not. We can always apply different physical and chemical means to check the quality of the environment, that how good the environment is. However, if we apply extra agents to the environment, those agents themselves can cause so many side effects to the environment. So it is a best idea to use already existing organisms that can respond to the environment under different circumstances and check how those organisms are doing, and indirectly we can assess the quality of the environment. Basically, whatever living organisms that we use to detect the quality of the environment, those living organisms are called as bioindicators. Aise jandar jinko hum dekh ke bata sakte hain कि जो एनवायरनमेंट है उसकी इस वक्त क्या हालात हैं, क्या वो ठीक जा रही है या उसमें कोई प्रॉब्लम्स आ रही हैं. सो बायो इंडिकेटर्स, बायो फॉर लाइफ, और ऐसे लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म जो कि इंडिकेट करते हैं कि क्या सूरत हाल है एनवायरनमेंट की. बायो इंडिकेटर्स आर लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म सच एज प्लांट्स, प्लैंकटॉन्स, एनिमल्स एंड माइक्रोब्स विच आर यूटिलाइज टू स्क्रीन द हेल्थ ऑफ द नेचुरल इकोसिस्टम इन द एनवायरनमेंट. Almost every type of living organisms can be used to detect the quality of the environment. For example, you can see here, plants ko use kiya ja sakta hai, ki plants, different organisms, same goes with different plants, they respond differently to different circumstances in the environment. We can use planktons. Planktons are basically those organisms which are free floating in the environment, mostly in water-based environments, and they just move along with the tide of the water. Those can be zooplanktons as well as phytoplanktons. Animals can also be used to detect the quality of the environment, and so can be the microorganisms. It is said that microorganisms are perhaps the best detector of the environments. So you can see here, instead of applying any new technology or any new agent to the environment, the scientists are using already existing living organisms, and they are indirectly assessing the quality of the environment. The expression bioindicator is used as an aggregate term referring to all sources of biotic and abiotic reactions to ecological changes. Now, environment can be deteriorated by different means. It can happen naturally, or it can happen through anthropogenic activities due to the activities of human beings. And the environment can be harmed by abiotic factors, for example, climate, extreme climates, or it can be harmed by biotic factors, which are obviously living organisms. So in any case, whatever factor is there that is affecting the environment, the changes that happen in the environment are directly or indirectly expressed on the life and life quality of the living organisms. So we can see living organisms and we can indirectly assess the quality of the environment. These bioindicators are used for assessing environmental health and biogeographical changes taking place in the environment. For example, a plankton responding rapidly to changes taking place in the surrounding. As we just discussed, we can use different types of microorganisms and different types of living organisms to detect the environmental changes. And the word used here is biogeographical changes. Obviously, whatever changes happen in the environment at the geographic level, they ultimately affect the biology of that place as well. Even the health of aquatic flora is best reflected by plankton, which acts as an early warning signal. For different types of environments, different types of living organisms are best suited as bioindicators. مختلف طرح کی environment کے لحاظ سے مختلف طرح کے جانداروں کو استعمال کیا جا سکتا ہے دیکھنے کے لیے کہ کیا صورتحال چل رہی ہے انوائرمنٹ میں. اور سیکنڈ, نہ صرف انوائرمنٹ میٹر کرتی ہے بلکہ کس قسم کا پلوٹنٹ ہے وہاں پہ, اس کے مطابق بھی چوز کیا جاتا ہے لیونگ آرگنزم کہ کون سا لیونگ آرگنزم بہتر طریقے سے رسپونڈ کرے گا ٹو سرٹن پلوٹنٹ. دی آر سرٹن فیکٹرز وچ گورن دا پریزنس آف بایو انڈیکیٹرز ان انوائرمنٹ سچ ایز ٹرانسمیشن آف لائٹ, واٹر ٹمپریچر اینڈ سسپینڈیڈ سالڈز. There are so many factors that affect the lives of living organisms existing in the environment. Usme se bahut sare hain, humne pehle baat ki, bahut sare factors ho sakte hain jo ke biotic bhi ho sakte hain aur abiotic bhi ho sakte hain. All of them collectively affect the life of the living things living there. Through the application of bioindicators, we can predict the natural state of certain region or level degree of contamination. Again, the same thing. Now, bioindicators can tell us what is going on in the environment, if there is some pollution existing in the environment. and they can also tell us the extent of the deterioration in the environment as well. There are so many different advantages of using bioindicators instead of using any other means to detect the changes in the environment. For example, biological impacts can be determined easily, basically. सबसे आसान तरीका क्या है इफ यू कैन पिक एंड चूज इफ यू कैन सेलेक्ट अ सर्टन ऑर्गेनिज्म टू डिटेक्ट द क्वालिटी ऑफ द एनवायरनमेंट सबसे आसान तरीका क्या है यू जस्ट काउंट द नंबर ऑफ दैट स्पीशीज कि पहले इतने थे अब कितने हैं क्या कम हो रहे हैं या ज्यादा हो रहे हैं सो इनडायरेक्टली यू कैन असेस द क्वालिटी ऑफ द एनवायरनमेंट टू मॉनिटर सिनर्जेटिक एंड एंटागोनिस्टिक इम्पैक्ट्स ऑफ वेरियस पोल्यूटेंट्स ऑन अ क्रिएचर व्हाटएवर फैक्टर्स आर अफेक्टिंग द एनवायरनमेंट दोज कैन benefits some types of living organisms. On the other hand, those can harm the other types of living organisms. Moreover, living organisms work together as well. For example, sometimes they work together to benefit each other, and sometimes they work against each other. So all these factors can be monitored, and indirectly, the quality of the environment can be assessed. Early stage diagnosis as well as harmful effects of toxins to plants as well as human beings can be monitored. It is said that if we use bioindicators to detect the quality of the environment, these indicators are the most sensitive to the changes in the environment, and they can tell us the happenings going on in the environment at very early stage. So that's why they are one of the reasons why they are best suited to detect the quality of the environment. These bioindicators can be easily counted due to their prevalence. An economically viable alternative when compared to other specialized measuring systems. Basically, you don't have to spend much money to detect the quality of the environment if you are using bioindicators. Why so? Because they are already existing in the environment naturally. Jitne bhi living organisms environment mein paaye ja rahe hain already, aap unhi ko use karte hain, unki health ko dekhte hain, maybe unki population number ko dekhte hain, etc. to detect the quality of the environment indirectly. So this was about what bioindicators are. We'll move on to further details of bioindicators in our next lessons.